My name's Dave Collins, and I live in Lakeland, Florida, and I own Paint Along Studios. And I had polio, and I contracted polio when I was 5 years old, before the polio vaccine came out. When I was diagnosed, the first thing that happened is, of course, when you have polio, it's just like any other virus. It has a time that you're able to communicate the disease to other people, which is about 20, 21 days, which I think is what, you know, typical viruses are. You have runny nose, you have, you know, maybe a headache, you have some stiffness, you know, just all the symptoms you would have with any other virus. But after a while, I started dragging my leg. And my parents' first reaction was, stop that. You know, I mean, what are you doing? Stop doing that. Why you keep walking around, you know, doing that all the time? Walk right. Then I started getting a stiff neck, and I would hold my neck in a strange position. So I'm dragging my leg and with the stiff neck, and my parents saying, stop that. Quit holding your head that way. Sit up straight. Because, of course, you know, what do they know, you know, as far as, you know, what you might have or so forth. In some ways, it's how I happened to be an artist. At that time, everyone who contracted polio, they put in a polio ward. I was in a polio ward with 70 other kids. A guy came in and started doing caricature art. And he would say, what is your name? And you say, I'm Dave Collins. And he would take the D and make a ear out of it, and the C and make another ear out of it, and put a cowboy hat on and give you a big smile and some freckles and, you know, put your name there, Dave Collins. Well, one day after he had gone, I thought, you know what? I think I can do that. Well, there's 70 kids in the ward. And I did every one of them. So when the guy came back a second time to the polio ward to entertain the troops, as it was, they asked me to go up on stage and do it with him. When somebody liked me for what I did rather than felt that I was strange because I was limping and had polio, then that became something I wanted to do more of. The reason I paint is because I had polio. So the road to recovery included the 7 months in the hospital, but also surgery. After the surgery, I was like most everybody. I could walk normally and I did my exercises and so forth. In the last few years, things of course have taken a little bit of a bad turn. Some of the surgery that they did fused the heels in my the bones in my heel. And as you age, those bones are supposed to slide down between each other, and they don't. So as a result, it takes my foot and twists it. So I'm developing almost like an arthritic situation. It's placing all of the weight on the ball of my foot, and because it does, that pressure causes the meat to move back away to where you only have just skin and bone. So I wear orthotics to help with that, but it's going to continue to get worse and worse. So in some ways, it's like post-polio syndrome. You know, you can have all kinds of effects from what happened. Polio affects the nerves, but after it affects the nerves, it causes atrophy in the muscle, and then the muscle, because it is then overworked, there's more strain on it than on normal people because it's been trying to be normal when there wasn't enough muscle there to be normal. So as you get older, it causes you to, you know, have these problems, limp and so forth. I still refuse to limp. All of my life, I've wanted to be just like you. I didn't want to be the kid who had polio. So even now, when it hurts, you're not going to know it, because I'm not going to show it.
I'm Dr. Ed Vedder. I'm principal of the Ivy School at Bartow High, and I'm also a very proud Rotarian of the Bartow Rotary Club in Bartow, Florida. Rotary is an international organization that their primary goal is to bring business and international professionals together to make the world a better place, ethically, health-wise, politically, any way that we can. Our attempt is to make a much better world. One of the ways that I'm particularly interested in is the Polio Plus program that Rotary established. They began the program in 1985, and their goal is to completely eradicate polio from the world. Since they began, they have reduced the number of documented polio cases worldwide by 99%.
Now, just watch this. This is absolutely wonderful. That's where we were when we started. Now just watch. Who says we can't eradicate polio?
And they've done this primarily through raising funds for their Polio Plus program through local clubs, through international clubs, through fundraisers, individual donations, all of it going to the Polio Plus Foundation and used to eradicate polio.
On behalf of all of us at the Gates Foundation, I'd like to extend our heartfelt thanks to Rotary members worldwide for your extraordinary efforts to defeat polio. Not every organization would be able to rise to a challenge like this one, but then again, no other organization is like Rotary. That's why the Gates Foundation recently announced a $100 million challenge grant to support Rotary's campaign to defeat polio. This grant is our vote of confidence in Rotarians around the world and in your partners in the Global Polio Eradication Initiative. We believe very strongly that you will achieve what you set out to do. We hope that this challenge grant will be a catalyst for the final stages of your campaign and help bring in even more funds to support the cause. I know that all Rotarians feel responsible for keeping the promise that your organization made more than two decades ago. I feel certain that you'll keep that promise, and in doing so, you will benefit the world for many generations to come.
When the last chapter on polio eradication is finally written, it will tell one of the most spectacular success stories in public health. It will describe one of the world's most remarkable partnerships, and it will highlight your personal service to humanity. Today, Rotary's leadership is more critical than ever. Your determination and generosity will drive us to the finish line in our race against polio. I know you will go the distance, and I will be with you every step of the way.
Primarily, this is done through visits to countries where there are known cases of polio, where there is a high population density in underdeveloped countries, where there are unsanitary conditions, all of these leading to a greater probability that polio would be found in these countries.
I hope you believe we can eradicate polio. And those who say we can't, I think, are on the wrong side of the argument.
Through immunization of newborns up to age one, this is primarily our frontal attack to eliminate and reduce polio. But we also do immunizations for children up to 5 years of age. So far, as I said, we've had a 99% reduction in the number of polio cases worldwide, but we are still left with a few hotbeds of polio worldwide. That's in Afghanistan, in Nigeria, and in Pakistan.
Well, there were hundreds of us, literally thousands, that had polio in the United States. It's been eradicated here. It's been eradicated in most of the world. We still have problems in Nigeria and Pakistan where it hasn't been taken care of.
Polio eradication is realistic. Are you with us?
Thank you.
Thank you.